उत्तरं भागं वेगवत्याश्च दक्षिणं कामात् अधिवसञ्जीयात् कश्चित् अद्भुतकेसरी तपन इन्दु अग्निनयनः तापानपचिनोतु नः तापनीयरहस्यानां सारः कामासि काहरिः आकण्ठम् आदिपुरुषं कण्ठीरवम् उपरि कुण्ठितारातिं वेगोपकण्ठसङ्गात् विमुक्तवैकुण्ठबहुमतिमुपासे बन्धुमखिलस्य जन्तोः बन्धुरपर्यङ्कबन्धरमणीयं विषमविलोचनमीडे वेगवती पुलिनकेळि नरसिंहं स्वस्थानेषु मरुद्गणान् नियमयन् स्वाधीन सर्वेन्द्रियः पर्यङ्कस्थिरधारणाप्रकटितप्रत्यङ्मुखावस्थितिः प्रायेण प्रणिपेदुषां प्रभुरसौ योगं निजं शिक्षयन् कामानातनुता अशेषजगतां कामासिका केसरी विखस्वर नखस्वर रुधिर हिरण्यवक्षस्थली विनर्गळ निरर्गळ रुधिर सिंधु संध्यायिताः अवन्तु मदनासिका मनुज पंच वक्त्रस्य माम् अहं प्रतमिकामितः प्रकटिताः वा बाहवः सटापटल भीषणे सरभस अट्टहासोद्भटे स्फुरत्कृति परिस्फुटत् भ्रुकुटिकेऽपि वक्त्रे कृते कृपाकपटकेसरीं दनुज डिम्ब दत्तस्तना सरोज सदृशा दृशा व्यतिभिषज्यते व्यज्यते त्वयि रक्षति रक्षकैः किमन्यैः त्वयि च अरक्षति रक्षकैः किमन्यैः इति निश्चितधीश्रयामि नित्यं नृहरे वेगवती तटाश्रयं त्वाम् वेरि गुड् ईवनिङ्ग् टु दि गेदरिङ्ग् हियर् इम्मेन्स् डिलैट् टु बी इन् मै वेरि ओन् सिटि एण्ड् टु बी एड्रेस्सिङ्ग् अ गेदरिङ्ग् in a style often synonymous with Harikatha or Sangeeta Upanyasam in the Uttarayana Punyakalam, a day which is just after Mahashivaratri, and the topic chosen for the delineation is Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam. Even before I could get deeper to understanding what are the nuances as stated by Saint Tyagaraja, this avataram of Sri Nrisimha avataram holds immense importance in Sanatana Dharma. Of course, when we refer to scriptures, we often have Srimad Ramayanam and Sri Mahabharatam as the itihasams. Of course, we have a gamut of about 18 Puranas that constitute the basket, the Purana Samuchayam. Nrisimhavataram appears in the seventh kandam of the skandam of Srimad Bhagavata Mahapuranam. It also appears briefly in the first amsham of Sri Vishnu Puranam. Ramayana doesn't make a very clear reference to Nrisimhavataram. Neither does Krishna avataram too. But the impact of this avataram is so much so that while Adi Shankara was commenting upon each of the holy names of the Lord, the thousand names, Geyam Gita Namasahasram states he in Mohamudgaram, which is Bhajagovindam. While commenting upon the thousand names of Sri Vishnu Sahasranamam, the last set of names arise. Devaki Nandana Srashta Kshitishaha Papanashanaha Shankhabrin Nandaki Chakri Sharangadhanva Gadadharaha Rathangapanihi Akshobhyaha Sarva Praharanayudaha. These are the names stated by Bhishmacharya before he concludes with Vishnu Sahasranam. He says, the one who is adorned with the Chakram, Chakri, Sharangi, the one who holds a bow called Sharangam, as he keeps referring to the Lord, the one who holds the weapons, he concludes it with one namam, which is Sarva Praharana Yudhaha. This is the last name. So if you're all been contemplating as to what unique name you should christen your baby, grandchild or child with, here is a name, Sarva Praharana Yudhaha, a simple one. So what does this name state? Adi Shankara says, the one who has got bored of using the shankham, the chakram, the gadha, the sharangam, is now trying to innovate and check if he could come up with a newer weapon, and that was his nails. So the one who was capable of using the nails as his weapons is called Sarva Praharanayudaha, states Adi Shankara. So the one who is capable of using the nails is of course Nrisimhavataram, because a Kshatriya is not supposed to use his nails. He is to use a weapon. That is the general rule. But in Ramavataram, incidentally, there is one place where Vibhishana comes and seeks asylum at the feet of Rama. He comes from another country seeking refuge. The act was amended. He was given asylum, and once he saw safe conditions in his country, he went back. So that was the act in those days. Now when Vibhishana comes and seeks asylum, there is a huge debate as to whether to accept him or not. At that point in time, there were various views. Humans are not known to give divergent views. Each human is known to give divergent views. That's the beauty. We are a many-to-one function in set theory. So while views were sought, there was one view as to how to take or ferry these 70,000 monkeys to Lanka when there's no route there. That is when he seeks the permission, clearance, eco-clearance from the ocean king. So Rama lays on the bed of Darbha as Darbhashayana Rama, even today venerated as Tirupullani. The prasadam in the temple is more famous than the Lord. It is called the Payasam. So while he rested for 3 days and expected the ocean king to answer, the ocean king did not come. He was absolutely Indian by nature. So he didn't respond in 3 days. That is when the Lord gets absolutely angry. He says, Chapamanaya Saumitre, O you obedient son of Sumitra, get my bow and the quiver of arrows. He yells. At that point in time, Lakshmana asks, if you're angry, how are we going to take these monkeys? He says, out of that fit of anger that he has, Angulyagrenatan Hanyan Ichanna Hariganeshwara. With the tip of my nails, I will dry up the oceanic waters and take them. The commentator immediately asks, how can a Kshatriya use nails? He says, this man must have remembered his previous Nisimhavataram and must have spoken. So even in Ramavataram, there is Nisimha. In Krishnavataram, the princess, the celebrated one of the Vidarbha region in Maharashtra, the current day Nagpur, the style of Sanskrit spoken in Nagpur, which was called Vaidarbhi, was the purest of all. So here was a princess called Rukmini who was born with a set of absolutely useless brothers. So while one of them fixed the marriage of Rukmini with another, the pinnacle of uselessness called as Sishupala, she writes an ode of love, a love letter in Sanskrit of 7 verses. It comes in Bhagavata Mahapuranam, Ekadasha Skandam. Shritva gunan bhuvana sundara shinvatante nirvishya karana vivaraihi haratongatapam rupam drisham drishimatam akhilattalabam tvai achyuta avishati chittam apatrapam me is the first verse. So goes every verse. At one point in time, Rukmini says, Oh Krishna, I've been in love with you head over heels for so many years. We haven't had the opportunity to meet really, virtually, or through social media. I just know of you as being a wonderful person. I haven't seen you. However be you, I would like to marry you. But my marriage is going to happen with one person called Chaitya of Chedi Desha called Sishupala. I know you to be the lion amongst men. Kale Nrisimha Naraloka Manobhiramam. At that point, what she meant, the commentator Veeraraghavacharya states, at that day when Prahlada said, my lord, is pervading in the pillar as well as in the blade of grass to exemplify the words of your devotee. That day you emerged out of the pillar. The rest of the sentence is still unfulfilled. You have to come from a blade of grass. So let you come from the leaf that I light because you are a Nrisimha again. So in Rama Avataram there is a mention of Nrisimha. In Krishna Avataram there is a mention of Nrisimha. An avataram which lasted for 1 hour and 24 minutes has made such an impact. And Rama lived for 11,000 years and he managed to buy a house last year. And here is Nrisimha, who has no real estate issues for the very reason that he can assert where his position is. So Nrisimha is going to be the supporting character of our delineating work today, while the protagonist is his devotee, who's Prahlada. To that Prahlada and to his hero Nrisimha, and there's no better state than ours. Namma Pradeshadalli iruva district, Bellari anta heltivi alve. Bellari comes from, historians opine, from the root word Bilahari. Hari in Sanskritam also means Nrisimha. The Lakshmi Nrisimha statue worshipped during the times of Krishna Devaraya after the Bahamani invasion was later converted to a Yoga Nrisimha. Because Lakshmi was taken away. Then it was converted, historians opine. So, Bilahari is Nrisimha and Bellari is Nrisimha. And what better a composition in Bilahari of Tyagaraja that we are going to relish now.
Yeah.
The composers that we have been blessed with in this beautiful country that is still a living civilization, of course, the Trinity occupy a special place, not that others don't. They've been often grouped together. And in the Trinity, we have known the beautiful Swarajatis of the eldest of the three, Shama Shastri, the group Kritis of the youngest of the three, who is Muthuswami Dikshitar. While there are composition in silos of Tyagaraja, he is a very, very, very known for the two of the Gaya Natakams that he has presented. In Sanskrit literature or literature of any of the regional languages in our country, we have had Padyam and Gadyam. Padyam is generally poetry. And Gadyam is prose. For example, Tvai Rakshati Rakshakai Kimanyaihi. Tvai Cha Rakshati Rakshakai Kimanyaihi. This is simple poetry. But I can add beauty to it. For example, there is something called as Yamakam. Mrudu Hridaye Daye Mrititaka Mahite Mahite. Drida Vibude Bude Shuvitatat Madure Madure. This is called Yamakam. Where I repeat the word, but the meanings are different because it is Mrudu Hridaye Daye. But when you hear it, daye will come twice. Mrudu hru daye daye. Mridita ka mahite mahite. Mahite mahite will come. Interestingly, there was a poet during the times of Narayana Bhattadri, the celebrated poet of the magnum opus Narayaniyam around the 16th, 17th century. His friend who grew up near Tirunavaya, which is near Bharadapura, he came with the Kankana Bandha Ramayanam. So it will be like a bangle. So the verse has 32 letters. That is an Anushtup Chandas. You take the first two letters of the verse and put it in the last line as the last two letters. Then, for example, Vanamali Gadi Sharangi, it ends with Narayano Vishnu Vasudevo Bhirakshatu. This is the first verse. I put Vana at the last, then Mali will become the first word. So this will become the next verse. So as you keep shifting two letters, you will get meaningful shlokas and it will go like a bangle. So it's called Kankana Baddha Ramayanam. And there was one attempt made by a poet. We've had wonderful literature. We are a very blessed country. This is all I can say. At one point in time, there was a question. Shurpanaka, who had her nose being chopped off, she was humiliated, whichever word you put it. Some say punished, some say humiliated, whichever word. She had to go and speak about Rama and Sita to Karadushana and Ravana respectively. But she goes with her nose chopped off. Without the nose's intervention, you just can't speak because I should get the sound. So there was a question, how did she communicate? Immediately a poet wrote Shurpanaka Pralapaha, a work where if you close your nose and recite, you'll get that Ramayana. You don't have to involve your nose. When the great sage of Kanchi, Paramacharya, was offered obeisances by a Sanskrit poet, Paramacharya said, see, Ramanamam is so pure that I can't even use my lips to touch it. What do I do? He immediately wrote Niroshta Ramayanam. Your lips don't touch in that Ramayana. Massive and a splendid country we are. And today we are mining gold. And we have a literature of gold. Here, Tyagaraja gives us a natakam, which is a Gaya natakam, where it can be converted into music. So he was a Vagayakara, so he notates it and gives us. So he has given two natakams. One is Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam. The second is Nauka Charitram. One involving Prahlada, the other involving Krishna. Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam is the larger of the two. In this, he has used Padyam, Gadyam, because in Sanskrit, you generally use both. It's called a Champu. Bhojaraja's Champu, Anantakavi's Champu, this is a Champu. Now, he has even used Dvipadam, Khandam, Dandakam. He has used all forms of poetry and has made it Sanskritized Telugu and presented Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam, which is divided into five sections. He has not given a name for the section, so I thought, being an ardent devotee, I should give. First should be Acharya Sammandham. That is the first Angam. Second could be Dvaya Mahamantras Purvardham. Third could be Bhakti Twaradasha. Fourth could be Dvaya Mahamantrams Uttarardham. Fifth is Moksha Pradatvam. These are the names that I have given for the sections because he has not given. But looking at the contents, I have tried giving a name to those five sections. So it has got 45 kirtanams in 29 ragas. Are you going to do all of it today? No. Don't worry, be rest assured, you're going to be home for dinner. So, now, before we get into the natakam, we will give you a medley of those particular lines of Tyagaraja's compositions where he has used Prahlada as the protagonist. Something very special about this natakam even before we could get into this medley. The moment you hear Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam, you will expect Prahlada, Prahlada's Bhakti, a Hiranyakashipu, and finally the Lord coming out of the pillar as Nisimha. This natakam has everything but Nisimha. There's no Nisimha avataram in this natakam. Then who protected Prahlada? Tyagaraja says Rama came and protected. So the beauty of Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam is it goes without a Nisimha. But being a Nisimha fan, I can't do justice like this. So I have intertwined Bhagavatam suitably into the natakam to get to Nisimha avataram. We'll listen to the medley now.
Gari sani sa, gari sani dani, sari re ga, gama re gama bhagava.
As he begins the work of Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam, Tyagaraja, he pays his obeisances to those Bhagavatas who have lived during or before his period. Often there is a chronicle that gives the life history of these saints. It's called Bhakti Vijayam. Bhakta Vijayam. There we come across saints from the Abhang Parivar, from the Telugu tradition, the Tamil tradition, the Kannada tradition. So he pays his salutations to Purandaradasa, Kanakadasa, to Jnanadeva, to Namadeva, to Bhadrachala Ramadas. Something very unique, because 250 years before, where was access to knowledge? It was just knowledge that was garnered by the student from what his teacher would teach. So that was knowledge. But knowing about who the Bhaktas are and which territory they are living is not that easy. To travel to Tirupati itself was a task for a person in Tamil Nadu. So in the commentaries of the 10th and the 11th century, they would say that the boundary for the Tamil land will be Tirumala, and that is a foreign country, Mel Nadu. So that used to be the commentary. Vedanta Deshika, in the 13th century, while he commented upon a work in Tamil called Amalanadi Piran, through a work called as Munivahana Bhogam, in the third verse, Mandipai Vadavengadamamalai Vanavargal Sandishayaninnan Arangattaravinadayan is the pasuram. For that he says, Agastya Bhasha Deshattukku Yellai Nilamayulla Tirumalai Tirupadire. Agastya Bhasha Desham is Tamil Bhumi. For that is the boundary which is Tirumala Tirupati. So to go to Tirumala Tirupati was a task. So to know people who lived in the 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th century is easy for us today, because with the search engine optimization, which is very sure that we will commit spelling mistakes, even before we type, it takes you from the below and says, type this. So access to knowledge is simply splendid today. But then Tyagaraja pays obeisances to those poets to just say how much of devotion he has towards them. He summarizes this in a beautiful padyam, gadyam, which we will be listening now.
Shri Kalyana Parampara Saketa Puradivasa Samajavarada నీకారుణ్యము చేనేను ఈ కావ్యమును అర్చినాడన్ ఇంపుగ వినుమా శ్రీమత్పల్చన దౌబను భూమిని విలసిల్లున్నటి పురవరమున శ్రీరామ స్వరూపుడనడగు రామ బ్రహ్మార్యస్సుతుడు రాగరహితుడు కదక కసిపుడు ముండుగాదు చలంగునను తదయుని సకల బాధల పెట్టి మరియునాగపాశంబును నడమున గట్టి సాగరంబున వేయ సెలెచు మొదలు సుమ్మసిల్లిన వేక సొంబుగా నుండురాగతాళ మృదంగ రవళి చెమిగుడ నాగరికోబి నయము చేచెలగు భక్తాగ్రగణ్యుడై పరగు ప్రహ్లాద భక్తి విజయంబన బాగైన క్రిడిని అది శంభునిడి పుష్పహారంగాను ననివార నలిగించుదర సుతారమణ ధర సుతారమణ ధర
In Srimad Bhagavatam, we come across this particular narration as stated by Shuka Brahmam to Parikshit, where there is a Karya Vaikuntham. Shastram states about two Vaikunthams, Vaikuntham 1.0, 2.0. This 1.0 is often referred to as Paramapadam, Tat Vishnoho Paramam Padagum Sadapashyanti Surayaha tells Vedam. The only way to that abode, Shastram tells through Subala Upanishad, Nasa Punaravartate, Nasa Punaravartate, through the path of light, which is called Archidadi Margam, the sentient matter, which is called Jivatma, departs from the gross body, Sthula Shariram, to a Sukshma Shariram, and crosses seven worlds, crosses Uttarayana Punyakalam, crosses the world of lightning, Vidyut, and then reaches Viraja and then goes, where there is no path of return. This is called Archis, the path of Agni or light. This is not the Vaikuntham which we speak of in Puranas, because people go, visit the Lord, speak of their requests and come back. The moment they come back, then this Vaikuntham is called Karya Vaikuntham. So Karya Vaikuntham is the place where the four sons of Brahma, upon Brahma who created, Brahma created, because he was the Pashu, Abadhanan Purusham Pashum Tai Yajnam Barhishi Praukshan, tells Purusha Suktam. He was tied to the Upastambham as a goat, because Ajaha is the name of a goat as well as Brahma. So then he created, as per Purusha Suktam, sons who could bring about progeny. But these four sons lived a life of celibacy. They were Sanat Kumaras, the four. Sanaka, Sanantana, Sanatana, Sanat Kumara, the four. So they all marched to Vaikuntham, is what Bhagavatam states, and they had free access. No visa on arrival, no prior visa, nothing. They can get in and get out. They don't even have to tail tag or anything of that sort. They have to go. But with the seven boundaries of Vaikuntham, Sapta Prakara Madhye Sarasija Mukulod Bhasamane Vimane Kaveri Madhyadeshe Mrudu Tara Pani Rad Bhoga Pariyanka Bhage Nidra Mudra Virama Katinigada Shiraf Parshva Vinyastahastam Padma Dhatri Karabhyam Parichita Charanam Rangarajam Bhajeham, tells Parashara Bhattaraka. So the seven boundaries have a set of Dwarapalakas, watchmen. One set is Jaya and Vijaya. The moment we say Jaya, Vijaya, then it becomes Trilingam. It's Jaya, Vijaya, Kumuda, Kumudaksha. So this Jaya and Vijaya stop them. These four sons of Brahma, who are generally very seasoned, cultured and composed, got into a fit of anger and they cursed. These kind of stopping and questioning people is the act of arrogant humans. You are supposed to be celestials here. May you be born as humans. So if you curse, it is believed in Shastras, if you curse someone to be born on earth, it was the biggest punishment. So these people immediately are said to have asked, what is the way back? Emancipation. That is when they were given a choice, is supposedly said. One, through either seven births of being bhaktas, or three births where you show your disgust to the Lord, which is called Samrambha Yogam. They chose the latter. And they were born on earth. This is one part. This is not there in Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam. What I stated is from Bhagavatam. In Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam, Tyagaraja positions the Dwarapalakas as bhaktas to the Lord, and they get entry to the stage. Now you'll have to be very, very attentive when I say stage, because the moment a poet or the dramatist writes a work in those days, whichever language, they will have to perform that natakam on that stage. That is called arangetram. We often use that for dance, right? Even for natakam, you'll have to do arangetram. There is a beautiful four-pillared mantapam built during the 16th century, but which was erstwhile used by Kamban to do arangetram of Kambaramayanam in Srirangam temple opposite the Mahalakshmi Sannidhi. So arangetram, the earliest stage that we ever know of, even before most of the Western countries could know what their names were, we had a stage made of stone to present dramas. It was built in the 7th and the 8th century by Narasimha Varman the II on the ECR road in Chennai called Tiger Caves. That was the first ever stone stage ever known in this world to present dramas. Here we had Tyagaraja, who wanted to present this. So he introduces the Dwarapalakas. Dwarapalakas get entry to the stage, looking at the audience, singing praise of the Lord. Here, Tyagaraja gives birth to the evergreen composition called Vasudevayani, which we will hear now.
Vasavadi Surapuji Tote Sura Puji Tode Na
Narrator who comes on the stage and introduces the Dwarapalaka who's singing praises of the Lord, now directly takes us to that place where Hiranyakashipu, the tyrant father, wants to punish his obedient son Prahlada, and he puts him to a well of poisonous snakes, and the snakes go around Prahlada and they tie him up, and Prahlada, at this point in time, he's completely devoted to the Lord and seeks no other help. Asahaya Shura. That is when Tyagaraja says that this boy, who was enveloped with poisonous snakes, was taken by the ocean king, Samudra Raja. And the ocean king escorts Prahlada to his kingdom. He asks Prahlada to bless his throne by sitting on it. While Prahlada is seated, Tyagaraja says that Samudra Raja invoked the presence and blessings of Garutman. He asks Garuda to come and drive away the snakes. This is there in Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam. But I was wondering, because this particular incident of Garuda coming and helping Prahlada is not found in Bhagavatam or Vishnu Puranam. Where must he have got this idea? Then probably I got a hint that Tyagaraja, being an ardent Rama devotee and a Ramayana devotee, in Yuddhakandam, there are three places where Rama swoons in Yuddhakandam. Three places, low BP. So the first place is where Nagastram was issued by Indrajit, the valorous son of Ravana, and the snakes had tied around Rama and Lakshmana and all the other monkeys. Even before the medical practitioner there called Garuda Pandita could advise what was the solution, Vibhishana spotted Garuda flying to the battlefield of Lanka. As Garuda came, because it is believed in Shastram, that as Garuda flies, you can hear Samavedam. Netram Gayatram Uchehe. His eyes are Gayatri Mantram. Garuda is often regarded as Vedatma. He is the inner soul to Vedas. That is why, be it a temple of Vishnu or Shiva, during Kumbhabhishekam, you will find Garuda going around the temple. He is as an act of protection. This is a belief that Vedas protect the temple. Here, Garuda, as he flies, understanding the vibrations, the snakes uncoil around the bodies and they go into the holes of the ground. They automatically go. At this point in time, Rama wakes up and looks at Garuda and asks, "Who are you?" Garuda felt a lot perplexed. I've been carrying you for ages. And with a person of a short-term memory loss, you're asking me this question, who are you? Because Rama had promised at the commencement of Ramayanam, Atmanam Manusham Manye Ramam Dasharathatmajam. I am the son of Dasharatha, I am D. Ram. Only when that D is replaced with an N, we have a problem. So, I am D. Ram. And as D. Ram, I am a normal human being. Atmanam Manusham Manye. If my wife is lost, I will cry. If my child is missing, I will cry. If I have problems, I will cry. I am a normal person. Krishna Avataram was not like that. He ensured none of his wives were kidnapped. That's a different issue. So Rama was a normal human being. So Garuda comes. If Garuda has to come to that spot, he must have not adhered to what Rama had said. Rama said, I'm a normal human being. So for normal human beings, where does Garuda fly from Vaikuntha and come? But then when Garuda was told, Garuda knew the answer, a befitting reply to give to Rama. This has been mentioned by my Acharya's Acharya called Srinidhi Swami in a work called Manju Ramayanam. It seems just three cantos before in Ramayanam, Rama on his sojourn to Lanka, in Maharashtra, he saw a dying vulture bird called Jatayu, whose wings were chopped off by the sword called Chandrahasam of Ravana. Looking at the dying bird, Rama puts the bird onto his lap and inquires why, who has done this harm to you. And he says, Ravana has kidnapped your wife. And he says, I have been surviving this long, I have been holding my last breath to just convey this information to you, Rama. With your permission, I now depart. At that point in time in Ramayana, Rama says, you shall go to moksham. I give you emancipation. So this Jatayu must have got 101 in Vaikuntham. While Garuda was a lot perplexed as to whether should I help Rama who's suffering on the battlefield, Jatayu, being a Sajati of the bird community, he comes and tells Garuda, you go. Now if Rama asks, why did you come? I'm a normal human being. What will I say? Jatayu tells, go tell him, just three cantos before you gave moksham to Jatayu, were you a human being or a divine person then? Why are you questioning me this now? Because a normal person, when you see a dying dog or a cat, you would just try to sympathize with the cat. You won't say, oh cat, let you go to moksha. The cat will in turn ask, will you go? I'm still doubtful. So, here Garuda came and helped Rama. Getting an idea from this, a cue from this, Tyagaraja must have got into Garuda helping Prahlada. Garuda's movement, the way he flies, there is a meter in Sanskrit called Garuda Gati Bandham, the velocity in which he flies in the pattern. Vedanta Deshika has composed a shloka in Paduka Sahasram called Garuda Gati Bandham. And he has also composed a work, a poetry of a different pattern called Dandakam. I shall recite Garuda Dandakam to give you a sample of how Garuda flies. Garudamakhila Veda Nida Dhirudam Dvishat Pida Not Kantita Kunta Vai Kunta Piti Krita Skandha Mide Swanida Gatif Prita Rudra Sukirti Sana Bhoga Gado Paguda Spurat Kanta Kavrata Veda Vyata Vipamana Vijitvadi Pakalpa Vishvaryamana Svatavati Karatna Rochit Chatarad Nirajitam Kanti Kalloli Nirajitam Jaya Garuda Suparna Darvi Karahara Devadi Pahara Harin Divaukas Patikshipta Damboli Dhara Kina Kalpa Kalpanta Vatula Kalpodaya Nalpa Viradi Nodhetcha Matkara Daityari Daitya Vajaroha Nirdati Totkarsha Sankarshanatman Garutman Marutman Chakadish Satyadi Murte Nakaschit Samaste Namaste Punaste Namaha Namahidamajahatsa Pariya Paryaya Niryata Paksha Nilaswala Nodvela Patoti Vichi Chapeta Hatagada Patala Bhankara Samkrudda Nagendra Pida Sruni Bhava Bhaswanna Kashrenaya Chanda Tundaya Nrityag Bhujanga Bhruve Vajrine Damshtraya Tubhya Madhyatma Vidya Videya Videya Bhavaddas Hasyamapa Dayetha Dayetascha Me Manuranugada Bakshi Vaktraspurattara Kastava Kaschitra Bhanu Priyashekhara Strayatam Nastri Vargapa Varga Prasutif Paravyoma Dhaman Valadveshi Darpa Jvaladvala Khilya Pratignyavatirna Stiram Tattva Buddhim Param Bhakti Denum Jaganmula Kande Mukunde Mahananda Dogdhin Ahina Ahina Ahinantaka. So Tyagaraja puts forth the essence of this obeisance that Samudra Raja offers to Garuda to help through a beautiful kriti which is Vinata Sutarara. We'll listen to that. The very celebrated mystic poetesses of our tradition, one amongst the Alvars, she has given us two works. One is Tiruppavai, the second is Nachiyar Thirumuri. In Nachiyar Thirumuri, the last part is called Pattimaindador Kareru Baladevarku or Kirkanna Ittiritti Vilayadi Inge Bodha Kandire Ittamana Pashukkalai Inidu Marindu Neeruti Vittukkondu Vilayadi Vrindavanatte Kandome. This is the verse. This is as if there's a conversation between two women. The one asks, with these characteristics what I mentioned, have you found the boy? Pattimaindador Kareru Baladevarku or Kirkannai. Baladevarku or Kirkannai means the younger brother to Balarama. Ittirittu Vilayadi Inge Podha Kandire. Did you see him? The other girl will reply, I don't know whether I've seen the boy that you have mentioned, but I've seen another boy. Ittamana Pashukkalai Inidumarindu Neeruti Vittukkondu Vilayadi Vrindavanatte Kandome. The one who enjoys being in the company of the cows and the calves, I saw him in Vrindavanam. There is one verse, the third one. மேலாப்பின்கீழ் வெயில் காப்பான் வினதை சிறுவன் சிறகென்னும் மேலாப்பின்கீழ் வருவானை விருந்தாவனத்தே கண்டோமே. So, மாலாய் பிறந்த நம்பியை, the first one tells, the one whom I'm asking is the one who's possible of uttering every possible lie on this earth. மாலாய் பிறந்த நம்பியை, மாலே செய்யும் மணாளனை, ஏலா பொய்கள் உரைப்பானை இங்கே போத கண்டீரே. The other girl tells, I don't know whether the boy that you are mentioning is the boy that I have seen, but I did see a boy as he walked. There was a shadow on him that was cast that was moving along. And when I looked up, it was the shadow of the flying bird Garuda at the top. Mela pinkil veyil kaapan vinadai shiruvan shiragennum mela pinkil varuvanai vrindavanate kandome. I saw the younger son of Vinata flying because the older one is Aruna. The younger one is Garuda. And of Vinata, why should they say the son of Vinata? Because Vinata is one of the rarest persons in our Shastram who has got a Mangala Shasanam, a verse celebrated on her by Vedanta Deshika. Saikam, Panchashatamyam, Atanuta Vinata, Nandanam, Nandayishyan, Kritva Maulau, Tadakhyam. Just one small diversion from this topic. In Ramayanam, there's one place where Rama comes and seeks his mother Kaushalya's permission. Mother, plan A, I was to become the heir apparent. It has become plan B, I have to go to the forest. He was cool and composed about it. Kaushalya started lamenting. She said, have I been waiting for these many years to see you walk in the forest that has been infested with thorns and pelting stones? He says, no worries, mother. I shall go to the forest. I seek your blessings. Finally, after lamenting for a very, very long time, she says, oh, my dear son Rama, it comes in Ramayana, Ayodhya Kandam. She says, I bless you. I bless you with those verses. With those verses which Vinata blessed Garuda while he was on a mission to seek Amritam or Ambrosia from Indra. There's a verse. Yatha Vinata Yevena. Like how Vinata said. But those two verses, what Vinata said, they have not been mentioned. She says those two verses I'll see. But where are these two verses? It is there in Adi Parva of Mahabharatam. In Adi Parva of Mahabharatam, while Vinata bids farewell to her son Garuda, she tells, Pakshaute marutappatu chandrasuryaucha prishthataha shirashchapatu vanhiste vasavaha sarvatastanum ahamchate sadaputra shanti swasti parayana ihasina bhavishyami swastikare ratasada. These are the two verses in Mahabharatam. In our ancient civilization, every household, the mothers used to know the shloka. And when the child goes out of the house, they'll recite these two shlokas and send. So Vinata is very, very well known for giving these verses. That is why he says Vinata Sutarara. Not Garuda Rara. Garuda Rara anta shabdam chaptunnara ante nu correct undi kada. Ikkada prayogam chesina shabdam Vinata Sutarara. Fine. Now Garuda comes. When Garuda comes, naturally, the snakes uncoil and they go into the holes of the ground. But Tyagaraja says, Garuda came to that spot saying, Krishna, Krishna. It's in Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam. We started with Nisimha, then we went to Rama, and now Garuda is saying, Krishna, Krishna. How? He does not say why he says Krishna, Krishna. He must have, being a Rama Bhakta, he should have said, Rama, Rama. Why Krishna, Krishna? Again, I thought for some time. There is one work called as Harivamsham. In Harivamsham, there is one small anecdote. The anecdote goes like this. In Karya Vaikuntham, the Lord was reclining on the serpent couch. At one point in time, Garuda, who is the fervent servant to the Lord, he was also taking rest. He was in a sabbatical. That's one of the sophisticated works to say that I'm on bench. So he was on a sabbatical. And the moment Garuda just went into a very, very powerful nap, power nap, he saw Prahlada's son Virochana get inside Karya Vaikuntham. It is there in Harivamsham. And Vedanta Deshika mentions this in Yadavabhyudayam. And the moment he gets in, he gets out. Virochana comes out with something hiding in his vastram, angavastram. Garuda checks what it is and he turns back and checks that the Lord's crown has been missing. So Virochana is into this act as well. So Garuda flies. Garuda Vega, incidentally the name of the couriers that carries pickles to the US. So he goes in Garuda Vega and fetches the crown back. On his way back to Vaikuntham, he sees with the bird's eye view of things on earth. He sees a beautiful kunda tree. And below the tree, the shade of that tree, is a beautiful blue sapphire-hued boy with cross legs holding the bamboo that has got a few holes and putting his fingers here and there ಕರದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಳಲನು ಬುದುತ ಮಾಡುತ್ತ ಸರಿಗಮ ಪದನಿ ಸೇಸ್ ಕನಕದಾಸ. ಸೊ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ನೌ ಪ್ಲೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಚಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಯ್. ಗರುಡ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಡೌನ್, ಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ರೌನ್ ಆನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗೋಸ್. ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ರೌನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಬೈ ವಿನತಾ ಸನ್ ವೈನತೇಯ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ವೈನತೇಯ ಮುಡಿ, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ತಿರುನಾರಾಯಣಪುರಂ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ವೈರಮುಡಿ. That is how the concept of Vairamudi came into Thirunarayanapuram. Because the Moolamurthi is treated as Krishna, the Utsava is called Ramapriya. Now that is why Garuda must have come with this Krishna Bhakti, that is why he must have said Krishna Krishna. Now, as Garuda flies to that spot, the snakes go away. And Garuda, once his job is done, he leaves. Now Prahlada, he converses with Samudra Raja. He tells, see, I would like to get an association with Bhagavatas, devotees like you, Samudra Raja. Samudra Raja says, I am no devotee, Prahlada. There are greater people. These are the names listed later by Tyagaraja. Parama Bhagavata Mouni Varasa Shivi Bhakara Sanaka Sanandana Disha Surakim Purusha Kanakaka Shipusuta Narada Tumburu. He gives a list. So these are the Bhagavatas. Prahlada says, but I am not able to see Hari in my vision. My bhakti has not reached that level. Hey Samudra Raja, can you tell me how Hari is positioned in Vaikuntham? They say that you have got access to Vaikuntham. How is he? So that is when he says, Hari is seated with one leg folded, the other leg extended in Virasanam. He has got Shri Devi, Bhudevi, Neela Devi, Samasta Jananim Vande, Chaitanya Stanyadayinim, Shreyasim, Srinivasasya Karunamiva Rupinim, Vande Vrishagirishasya Mahishim Vishvadarinim, Tatkripa Pratighatanam Kshamaya Varanam Yaya, Nishamayatu Mam Neela Yadbhoga Patalaidruvam, Bhavitam Srinivasasya Bhaktadosheswa Darshanam. These three have been listed by Nammalvar. Yen Thirumagal Sher, Marvane Yennum, Ennudaya Aviye Yennum, Nindiruvait இடந்தினி கொண்ட நிலமகள் கழ்வனே என்னும் அன்னினி தழிவிவேள் கொண்ட ஆய்மகள் என் அன்பனே என்னும் நின் திருவயிற்றால் இடந்தினி கொண்டானே என் செய்கேன் என் திருமகட்கே இஸ் அ திருவாய்மொழி பாசுரம். So the Lord is positioned that way. Potanna beautifully in the Untimitta Kshetram Ekashila Nagaram. He says in Bhagavatam, Ala Vaikuntha Nagarilo Purambulo. Incidentally, that's the name of a movie. Vaikunthapur, Ala Vaikunthapurambulo Nagarilo. So that's the beautiful description of Vaikuntham that has been given. Prahlada enjoys this and he says, I salute to that Lord of Vaikuntham. Who is the Lord of Vaikuntham? See, this is a lecture, I will ask questions. Translation. Tell me, who, Lord of Vaikuntham? Srinivasa, Vishnu, Narayana. But for Tyagaraja, who will it be? Vandanamu Raghunandana was born then.
Vandanamu Raghunandana. Vandanamu Raghunandana. Rahu Nandana Setu Bandhana.
Our Puranas, while they narrate an event, they talk about the nuances of the event. But generally, they don't get deep into the feelings experienced by the characters. That's very unique about our literature, our Puranas and Itihasas. But something great about our poets who came much later is when they get into the feelings of each character. For example, what Sita felt, what she must have felt while she was housed in Lanka. There are 3-4 verses in Sundarakandam. Avyakta rekham iva chandra rekham, pramsuf pradugdham iva hema rekham, kshatra prarudham iva chandra rekham. These are all verses in Sundarakandam, just 3 or 4. But Vedanta Deshika expands this into a poem of 110 verses called Hamsa Sandesham. He tells what all feelings she must have undergone. Similar is the case with Alvars. Same is the case with the Vagekaras, be it Purandaradasa, Kanakadasa. They will express and they will throw their feelings into that particular composition. Same is the case with Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam. Prahlada, upon understanding that this is how the Lord is positioned, he has to describe the Lord. But then he feels he has not got into that level of devotion. Every minute he will start feeling. For the Nayika, in the Nayika Bhavam, where you have the hero and the heroine, it's called Viraha Tapam.
Nindati Chandana Mindu Kirana Manu Vindati Kheda Madhiram Vindati Nindati Chandanam.
For Radha, who's without Krishna, or Krishna without Radha, when they take a beautiful cup of sandal paste and apply, which is meant to cool, he says,
Nindati Chandanam.
I don't like this sandal.
Indu Kirana Manu.
The rays of the nectarine moon is burning me. Because this is Viraha Tapam. Likewise, Prahlada experiences the same Viraha Tapam. Because in our Shastram, every man or the woman born in Shastram is treated as a female. You can say, I'm a Raymond, complete man. But Shastram doesn't call it. Then also, it says, you're not YY, you're XY. You still have that X allele in you. The one who has YY is the Lord. So he's Purushottama. So Prahlada experiences the Virahatapam. And now he starts lamenting. He says, why am I in this position? I shouldn't be talking about devotion or knowledge because that should come naturally to me because I was blessed with knowledge and devotion while I was in my mother's womb. This is the sentence Tyagaraja says. He doesn't get deep into this. But Puranam tells. You must have heard, this is where we are going to get into Bhagavatam. There was a rishi called Kashyapa. I've told this many times in many of my lectures. If you have heard these in my lectures many a times, discount me of this repetition. And hear as if you're hearing for the first time. So, we had a rishi who had the ability to see and foresee. Pashya. So his name was Pashyaka. When you derive a noun from a verb, you'll have to reverse the word. So Pashyakaha Kashyapo Bhavati. Pashyaka will become Kashyapa, says Aruna Prashnam. So this Kashyapa had many set of wives. One set is Vinata and Kadru. Other set is Aditi and Diti. Diti came and expressed her interest in having children with the Rishi. The Rishi said, this is not the right time for us to get together. It's a Raudra Muhurtam. Children who are born in such a way will not seek permission and will protest. Be very careful. So she said, it doesn't matter. I want two children, that's all. Whether they're irresponsible, responsible is not my concern. She produced two children, Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu. One whose eyes were as yellow as the gold. I'm talking on the right day. And the other whose body is that of gold. We are striking gold everywhere today in India. So Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu. Hiranya is gold. Hiranyavarnam, Harinim, gold. Shastram, whenever it has to talk something very pure, it will always take gold. So gold is incidentally in Sanskrit called Suvaranam. And it doesn't have much affinity towards silver, though it is the less expensive of the two. It will say Durvaranam. In Sanskrit dictionary, silver is called Durvaranam. But nobody generally uses. We have to sell silver also, right? If I say Durvaranam, who will buy? So we say Rajatam, Rajatasrajam. So Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu were born. True to the prediction of the prophecy, they were totally irresponsible and antisocial. This Hiranyaksha, he did not want to trouble people on earth. He wanted to trouble earth. So it is believed he took her and placed her into the oceanic waters of deluge, not Atlantic, Pacific, Bermuda Triangle. This is another ocean. Don't ask me where. I'm neither an astronomer nor astrologer. I believe what Shastras say and what my Acharyan says. I believe there is no harm to the society, monetary loss to anybody if I believe this. So as long as this is there, I believe. So there is an oceanic water of deluge with a different viscosity. The only place where my chemical engineering comes to rescue is using such jargons. Viscosity, turbulent flow and lamellar flow. So now earth was put into and she drowned. There was a thin layer of moss that enveloped her. So she immediately sought the help of her husband. The Lord appeared as Varaha. Udhritasi Varahena Krishnena Shatabahuna tells Vedam. Pashiturthu kidanda parmagatku pandurunal mashudambin nirvara manamila panniyam teshudaya tevar tiruvaranga chelvanar peshirippanagal perkavum perave tells Andal. Nammalvar tells Kolamalar Pavaikku Anbagi and Anbeyo, Nilavara Irandibarai Kabi Nibrundadoppa, Kolavara Hamunna, Nilan Kotirangunda Yendai, Nila Kadal Kadindai, Umai Petini Pokuvano. She was rescued. Hiranyaksha was killed. In Chennai, there is a wonderful cliche to tell this. Potu Thalradu. You are all very innocent. You may not know. Potu Thalradu means push and kill him. So this man was dead. His body was brought to the Sabha Mantapam. Immediately, Hiranyaksha's wife, Rishabhanu, and mother, they came and lamented over the death. The world has lost an irresponsible person like you. They lamented. Immediately, Hiranyakashipu comes and says, see, don't cry. What has departed is the Atma. Shariram is any day perishable. Shariram is anityam, Atma is nityam. This is called Hiranyakashipu Gita. Hiranyakashipu Gita is there, 4 verses in 7th canto of Bhagavatam. He was also a learned man, just that his learning was very selective. And that used to come to his rescue very selectively. So he immediately said, don't worry. And now he changed his mind. He said, I am going to take revenge on the Lord who killed. Kutehite Vishnu. Kutehite means the one with a puzzling nature. So he had to obtain powers through penance and austerities. So he tells Kayatu, his wife, Hiranyakashipu tells his wife, I am going on an on-site project for doing penance. Take care, bye. She immediately said, please see my HCG report. And she was pregnant. He immediately tweeted, congratulations. And he left. He goes and performs penance towards Lord Brahma. Brahma is regarded as Ashutoshi. Immediate result. But he may not think what will be the consequences. He will promise in haste and repent in leisure. So he gave commitment. What is that dialogue? Main ek bar commitment deta hun to uska main bhi nahi sunta. So Brahma came and he asked Hiranyakashipu, what do you want? Hiranyakashipu said, I want immortality. I should not die. Brahma said, you have not read Article 14 and 17 of our constitution. If you are born in Vedic constitution, you should die. If you are born, you should die. Simple rule. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. That if you want to be born again, you'll have to die now, then next. Now in Karnataka, next maybe in Andhra or I don't know where. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, says Adi Shankara. So you have to be born. Ask your boon in a different way. Don't ask for immortality because I am myself not immortal. After 49 years of my lifetime, another Brahma will come. Then we'll say Adya Brahmanaha Dvitiya Pararthe. Next Brahma will come. So Brahma, my position itself is not stable. Don't ask me this boon. Ask in a different way. In engineering, we all come across a course called optimization. Those of you who have got certificate in engineering, my heartiest condolences. But now, the point is there is a course called as optimization. You have to ask the same thing in a different way. He said, I should neither die outside my house or inside my house. Neither in space nor on earth. Should neither be killed by a human nor an animal. As he kept on laying one condition after the other, Brahma started sweating. He knew he was to lose his job. Anything else, Hiranyakashipu? Brahma asked. Hiranyakashipu said, yes, it is still there. Baki hai mera dost. What is it? I should neither be killed by an animate object nor an inanimate object. So if you use a snake, I should not die. If you use a weapon, I should not die. It should neither be daytime nor nighttime. Brahma said, anything left? Nothing. Just one thing. One small appendix note. The one who is to kill me, if at all one exists, should not fall under the gamut of your creation. You must have not created him. Brahma said, thank God, tathastu. Because he knows who has created him. And he left. Because his creator does not fall under the gamut of his creation. Simple. This is complement of A and set theory. A complement of universal set is what he asked. He did not know that there is something beyond Brahma too. He left. Meanwhile, on the other side, Kayatu, who was pregnant, was waiting for her husband to come from the on-site project. Knowing that she was pregnant through various news articles, Indra came. Indra has 4-5 FIRs on him in our Puranas. Because of his political clout, no action was taken. So he has kidnapped the sacrificial horse 3 times. Ashwamedha Yajna Ashwam. So Indra now kidnaps Kayatu. Don't ask me how did he kidnap? He must have given all this we see in movies, some medicine he must have given in her food. She must have fainted and taken. All this you'll have to imagine. Fill in the blanks. So he took her in his celestial elephant called Airavatam. While she was being taken, Narada, who is always a marketing person, he came that side. Varana Radhanarayana Smarana. So he comes. He asks, who is this lady Indra? This is Hiranyakashipu's wife. Why are you taking her? No, she is pregnant. If this child manages to survive, the child will be as ugly and cruel as the father. Indra, don't do that. It doesn't mean Hiranyakashipu, who's bad, will have a bad son. Your father was good. So, was taken. She was relieved. Narada said, I will take her to my hermitage. And in his hermitage, Narada reserved one room for her, labor room. And every night she used to be served with good food, whatever choice she wants, Thai cuisine, Mexican, lasagna, whatever. After that, he used to give her a lecture. That is the most dangerous thing a person can do. After dinner, you should not listen to Upanyasam. But Narada, that time probably that was his maiden lecture. So he gave her, served her food. She sat and he used to give lecture and she used to sleep. So much so at one point in time, she used to snore. This was a big insult to Narada Acharya. He stopped. As he stopped, he could listen. He could sense a sound that said, continue. He was wondering where that sound came from. Shastram tells it came from the fetus, the garbham. That was listening. Garbha Shriman. So Narada continued reciting the, or narrating the stories. So he was called Garbha Shriman. Now Prahlada says, despite me being a Garbha Shriman, after having got knowledge from Narada, why am I not getting the darshan of the Lord Hari? And then he sings a beautiful verse welcoming Narada Maharshi, who comes to the spot to clear the air. He says, Narada Muni Vedalina. We'll listen to that.
Bheda, bheda, rahita magu. Bheda, bheda, rahita magu.
Muni reaches the spot with his veena. Tyagaraja makes a mention of it. Narada's veena is called Mahati. Now, something very unique about the veena, a beautiful instrument that has had association with the deities whom we worship. And that is one of the instruments in Narayaniyam. Bhattadri, while describing Nisimhavataram in Dashakam 24 and 25, if I'm right. He says, Munehe Veenapanau. Muni, who is Narada, Veenapanau. He came with the Veena to bless Prahlada. Why? Because since he was there during the gestation period, in the 8th month, the Veena is played. Shastram tells the only instrument which the fetus can recognize in the 8th month is Veena. Munehe Veena Panau. And there is one specific mantra which Vedam tells you have to play during that Seemantonnayanam. Kannadadalli yen helutivi aa shabdakke Seemantonnayanane Pumsavana. Enu shabda? Seemantana. So it is played then. So Narada came with Mahati. But today, our conception of Veena is where there's a half pumpkin on one side, there's a smaller one on the other, there are strings attached. Kodam, we call it in Tamil. This form of Veena that we see is barely 350, 400 years old, this form. As designed and practiced by the kings of Madurai, called Nayaks. The Veena that was used before this period, we have no idea how that Veena looked. But there is one specific place in Halebidu temple where historians say this is how the Veena looked. It looks very different from the Veena that we know. So the instrument and the instrument's name and the music that emanated from it is all known. But the design that we know, now we see Saraswati Devi as produced by Ravi Verma with the Veena, right? We don't know if this was the Veena then. So he comes with the Veena. Tyagaraja being a great Vagayakara, he will give more importance to instruments as well. Narada comes and he gives a description of Vaikuntham. Initially, Samudra Raja gave. Right? Now he gives a description of Vaikuntham. How does Vaikuntham look? Vaikuntham in Shastram is supposed to be an abode ambasya pare bhuvanasya madhye nakasya prishthe mahato mahiyan. It is somewhere else. Sir, if it is somewhere else, have you seen it? No. Then how are you speaking ours together like this? Just because we are quite receptive and very patient audience, you are telling us. One thing which is very clear in Sanatana Dharma, underline this. There are three tools of understanding any object or God. Let's treat God as an object for some time. Any object you can recognize using three tools. The first is called Pratyaksham. Second is called Anumanam. Third is called Shabdam. So the first one is Pratyaksham. In Pratyaksha Pramanam, what we do is we give importance to our senses. I can see the fan, my eyes can see it. I can feel the fan because my skin can sense it. I can taste the water because my tongue has the ability to taste it. I can smell the agarbatti because my epithelial cells in my nose are working, functioning. I found some pieces of grain because there is earth. So the five bhutas can be recognized with my five senses, jnanendriyas. So this is called perception, which is pratyaksham. Very, very strong tool of sensing an object. Second is anumanam. Anumanam is inferring or inference. Suppose I see a pile of smoke somewhere, I wouldn't run 5 kilometers to find what is causing that smoke. I will immediately conclude there is fire. So there is smoke. I haven't seen the fire, but I conclude there is fire without seeing. But this could also go wrong. Anumanam can go wrong. Imagine I order through Swiggy. 3 scoops of black currant from Baskin and Robbins. He will give me a box. When I open, I'll find smoke coming. But that is not because of fire. That's because of dry ice. So my inference can also go wrong. Pratyaksham can go wrong. Inference can also go wrong. That is why Shastram is very clear. It doesn't say that God can be sensed through Pratyaksham. Because to a devotee, he is Ranganatha of Sri Rangapatnam. He is Varadaraja of Kanchipuram. He is Vithala of Pandarpur. To a non-believer, that is a stone. You cannot force that person to believe the God in it because he sees a stone. So perception can go wrong. Inference can go wrong. Then how do I believe? That is where Shastram tells. It's very, very liberal. It says, Shastrad Vedmi Janardhanam. Only through scriptures you will be able to believe in God. So for us, Pramanam is scriptures. So scriptures say Vaikuntham looked like this. So if you ask me whether you have seen it, I have not. But Shastram tells it looks like this. How it looks is a beautiful description given by Tyagaraja in a beautiful Gadhyam, which we will now listen to.
Jaya Jaya Sakala Nigamagama Kushala Kindara Kim Purusha Siddha Vidyadara Giyamana Bahu Jagadudaya Rakshana Nayahe Dubhuta Chaturanana Harihara Prabhriti Chintyamana Mani Dvipe Chaturanana Harihara Prabhriti Chintyamana Mani Dvipe Jita Sadhu Hatta Basakala Suramuni Nikara Nija Bhakta Jana Nichaya Hridaya Kamita Santana Saubhagya Dhanaka Nakavahanadi Ashtaishwarya Dayaka Chintamani Maya Maha Vaikuntha Nagare Netra Nandakare Chandamata Mandala Vilasat Sapta Hema Prakarantara Shobhyamana Bhaskara Koti Samana Vajra Stambhayuta Sahita Suvarna Mandapantare Shubhatare Navaratna Kachita Kanaka Mayaham Satulika Talpe Charchandra Koti Sarni Bhasheshatalpe. ಸುರನಾಯಕಾದ್ಯಷ್ಟ ದಿಕ್ಪಾಲ ಮಕುಟ ಮಣಿಗಳ ನಿರ್ಜಿತ ಪದಾರವಿಂದ ಜಗದಾನಂದ ಅನಂತ ಗರುಡ ವಿಶ್ವಕ್ಸೇನಾದಿ ನಿತ್ಯ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಜನ ಸಮೇತ ಮಹಾಪ್ರಭಾವ ಸಂಪನ್ನ ಅಖಿಲ ಭಕ್ತ ಜನ ಪ್ರಸನ್ನ ಉಭಯ ಪಾರ್ಶ್ವೋಜ್ವಲಿತ ಕರ್ಣ ಕುಂಡಲ ಸೇವಿತ ಮುನಿಮಂಡಲ ಭಕ್ತ ತ್ರಾಣ ಪರಾಯಣ ಶ್ರೀಮನ್ನಾರಾಯಣ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮೀ ಸಮೇತೋ ಮಹಾಭಗವಾನ್.
ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಂಪ್ಲಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ತ್ಯಾಗರಾಜಾಸ್ ಮಾಸ್ಟರಿ ಓವರ್ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತ್. ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಇನ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ವೇ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ leave any aspect of Sanskrit poetry lakshanam untouched. At the same time, he adheres every line to Shastram. Garuda Ananta Vishwaksenadi. This is the order in which Subhadra Upanishad tells. I don't have to give a certificate. Nevertheless, from reading Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam, you can say that he was a master in scriptures and Shastra. So this is a beautiful Gadhyam. Gadhyam is generally prose. So this generally cannot be set to Talam. But Gadhyam gives a very, very different feeling when you read it. So Sanskrit is blessed with Gadhyam and Padhyam. So here, Narada comes over to the spot, describes Vaikuntham, and Prahlada says, now that you have described Vaikuntham, tell me what they are talking. Narada said, see, I don't eavesdrop. I barge in. So I know what was happening. He says, there was a conversation between the god and the goddess. This conversation is very interesting because what happens in Sanatana Dharma is you don't keep God at a very high pedestal. You pull that God down to our level. That is why you can always pinch a Krishna. You can kick Krishna. You can't imagine a Westerner coming and asking, what do you do with God? And I say, I pinch. I scold him. Because we enjoy a very, very personal relationship with God. Sanatana Dharma gives you that liberty. You can choose not to talk to him for 3 days. He's still going to run behind you. So this is how Shastram has given us divinity. Here, we come across the conversation between the god and the goddess. I was wondering where this conversation idea must have stuck Tyagaraja. See, Tyagaraja lived on the banks of Kaveri, in that place where Kaveri branches into 5. Vennaru, Vettaru, Kudamurutti, Mudigondan, they're all the 5 tributaries. It's called Pancha Nadi Kshetram. Pancha in Tamil is I. Nadi is Aru. Ayyaru is Thiruvayyaru. So you've got 5 rivers. There's a beautiful Shiva temple, Panchanadishwara. Thirunavukkarasar in Tevaram describes this as Bhuloka Kailasham. And the goddess is called Dharma Samvardhini. She is the only one besides Kanchipuram and Madurai and Kamakshi that all the Trinity have sung. All the Trinity, Shama Shastri, Muthuswami Dikshita, and Tyagaraja, they have all 3 have sung on Madurai Meenakshi, Kanchi, Kamakshi, and Thiruvayyaru Dharma Samvardhini in Varadaraja of Kanchi. The 4 ones who have got Mangala Shasana by all the 3. Nannu Kanna Talli, Nabhagyama, Narayani, Dharmambike, and Tavuka Kirtana Undikada. Dharmambike, beautiful Kshetram. So he lived by the Kaveri banks. So if you go one side of Thiruvayyaru, you get Kumbakonam. And the other side, Tanjamanagari, which is Tanjavur. And you go further in Kaveri, beat about the flowing waters, you reach Srirangam. So his access to Vaishnavite scriptures must have been very high. Why, sir? Why? Because even a great Vagayakara called Uthukkadu Venkatakavi, who lived before Tyagaraja in a smaller hamlet called Uthukkadu near Swami Malai, describes in Ranganatha Manisham the names of all Alvars. So before him, people knew Alvars. So Tyagaraja knowing is not a big surprise. And amongst the Alvars, there are only two who have crossed the boundaries of Tamil Nadu. One is the father, the second is the daughter. Who is it? Periyalvar Andal. So they have become the protagonists of a beautiful work called Amukta Malyada in Telugu. In the 16th century, one of the celebrated kings of the Vijayanagara kingdom called Krishnadevaraya, in order to annex the Kalinga Desham of Orissa, travels via villages of Andhra Desham. See, whatever we know is Andhra. Today it is Telangana, Andhra. In those days, it was all one region, Andhra Desham. And the food of Andhra being spicy has been there for generations. Because Venkatadhwari Kavi in one place says, Lakshmi's tongue is as red as a person who consumes food from Andhra. He says in a Sanskrit verse. So nothing is new. And people of Karnataka, we have been very hospitable always. Because in the 13th century, Vedanta Deshika, who stayed in Satyakalapuri, tells, Sahaja Sulabha Dasya, the people of Karnataka are very hospitable, he tells. Avagivaga nam prasiddha yavudide anta helbarade. So we should tell about what is special about us, right? So here, in Andhra Desham, as he walks, Krishnadevaraya, he reaches a temple called Kakulandra Vishnu. This is not Sri Kakulam. There's another place, Kakulandra Vishnu. In Kakulandra Vishnu temple, Krishnadevaraya stays that night and the Lord appears in his dream and says, you being such a great warrior and a poet, why don't you write some poem on me? He immediately asks, what should I write on? What is the topic? He says, don't write on me. The Lord says, write on a lady who adorned garlands on herself first and then gave those adorned garlands to me. Malyada, Amukta Malyada. In which language should I write? He was a polyglot. Krishnadevaraya. The Lord says, it seems, Krishnadevaraya says, write in the language which is the sweetest of all, Telugu. The Lord says, Desha Bhasha Alandalaku, Telugu Lessa, write in Telugu. But we say Kasturi Kannada. Had the Lord been in our geography, he would have said Kannada, don't worry. Because this will reach Supreme Court now. Anything and everything, I'm worried what to have tonight. So, here we had Amukta Malyada, which is Periyalvar and Andal. So that has crossed boundaries. Tyagaraja must have had access to that because he was a person living in Tamil Nadu with Telugu roots. Correct? In Amukta Malyada, Periyalvar has been spoken about. Periyalvar gives an example of a conversation between the god and the goddess. He says that in Srirangam, Ranganayaki was pressing the lotus-like feet of the Lord. The moment I said this somewhere, immediately a few ladies got up. This is absolutely male-dominated. Why should she press the legs of the Lord? They immediately took some placards and held. I saw this is the only place where there is no protest. I said, here also protest has come. Then I said, see, whatever has been mentioned in Shastram is during the daytime. She presses the legs. We don't know in the night who presses whose legs. So I said, be composed, madam, and you sit. Then she agreed. And she sat. Now, the point remains that while Ranganayaki, the presiding deity of Srirangam, Ullasa Pallavita Palita Saptaloki Nirvaha Korakitanema Kataksha Leelam Sriranga Harmyatala Mangala Deeparekham Sri Rangaraja Mahishim Shriyam Ashrayamaha tells Parashara Bhattaraka. As she was pressing the legs of the Lord, she released her hands and she stopped. The Lord asked, why? She said, I am absolutely vexed by staying with you. Lord asked why. See, while I was housed in Lanka as Sita, this Ravana's brother Vibhishana goes and tells Ravana, release Sita immediately because the moment she has stepped into Lanka, there is huge loss in our country. Sensex has come down, Nifty has come down. Low economy, things are not selling, inflation is high. All because of Sita's entry to Lanka. Send her back. This is there in Yuddha Kandam. You can go check. Ravana immediately says, no, no, I will not release her. But these words where Vibhishana has admonished Sita's auspiciousness reaches the ears of Sita. So she has had not a very good opinion about Vibhishana. But now where is Ranganatha? The first of the Divyadeshams, the Lord is facing the south. Tendisai Ilangai Noki. Why? Vibhishana is staying there. She says, you are a mannerless man. He has abused me and you are looking at him. This conversation, what she had with the Lord, has been summarized by Periyalvar. Tannadiyar Tirattagattu. Tamarayal Agilum Shiragudaikumel. Even if it is the one who is seated on the lotus, who is Mahalakshmi, who complains, the Lord will say, he'll reply, Yennadiyar Adishayyar. My devotees would have not said that. No, he did say, I've got proof. Look at Times of Lanka paper. Treta Yugam. She has said, Yennadiyar Adishayyar. If he has said, Shaidarel Nandri Shaidar Yenbar Pol, if he would have said, he would have done that for your good. So this conversation has been written as a pasuram, and this pasuram's photocopy must have reached Tyagaraja. That is why Tyagaraja now tells a conversation between the Lord and the goddess through Narada to Prahlada. It seems the goddess was asking, why are you going to earth every now and then? She's asking the Lord, no, no, there are my devotees whom I have to protect. But I go very rarely. Don't lie. Just now you went and protected Dhruva. What do I do? Dhruva's father did not care for him. Dhruva's aunt did not care. So I had to go. Like this you are telling every time when you are going to earth. Now you are saying you have to go to protect Prahlada. Yes, poor boy. If I don't go, who else will go? Now I have a worry, my Lord, she tells. All this is there in Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam. The Lord asks, what? If you go there in the presence of Prahlada, he will imprison you in his heart. How will you get out? What reply you must have expected from the Lord? How to get out of the jail? You should say, I have lost 8 kgs. I have got these 11 ailments. Once you get released, all these ailments will go away. Now, he said, don't worry, I will pacify my devotee and come out. So, listening to this conversation, Prahlada feels a lot relieved. He tells Narada, Narada Maharishi, but still the Lord has not come. This is Virahatapam. He has still not come. What do I do now? Then he tells his lamenting through 2-3 kritis, which we have made it as a medley from Prahlada Bhakti. Please listen to that.
Oh.
Prahlada learns under the guidance of the sons of Shukracharya called Shanda and Amarka. He learns because the father recognizes a talent in him. The boy, while he was the age of two, the father asks, "Tell me something that you know." The father was expecting, "Scintillate, scintillate, you minusculic asteroid in the vast expanse of the splendid sky." What did I say? Twinkle, twinkle, little star. This was a Tharoor style, that's all. So he would have expected the son to speak. But the boy said, Vishnu Purana Shlokam, Shasta Vishnur Aseshasya Jagadoyo Hridisthitaha Tameva Paramatmanam Tata Kakkena Shasyate. This shloka has been used at least 10 times in the commentaries of Brahma Sutras by Adi Shankara and Ramanuja. Very important shloka. Father, the one who is the one who's commanding you from you, within you. Don't think this is like the me of the me of the me. Absolutely different. It's nowhere going to buying an island. So, here we had the boy tell that the one who commands you from the within you and me are the same. Look at the splendidness with which he brings about the universal philosophy. The father, who is obviously oblivious of the fact of philosophy and theology, takes the son to task and says that I have to put you to some course, crash course, because you have learned something from internet and you're lamenting, Shasta Vishnu, I don't like that name. He called Shanda and Amarka and said, teach my son who is Parabrahman. The teacher said, we will do it, sir. Teach him that I am Parabrahman. Sir, course material not available. That you are Parabrahman. He said, you design. They took Prahlada to the ashramam. There were already some trained students there. Next morning, the class was to begin at 7 a.m. tutorial. But instead, 4 a.m., the teachers were able to listen to 93.4 FM. Some song is going on. They went and saw Prahlada was the student research scholar. If you are a research scholar in a university, you should pass out of the university within a stipulated period. You should not stay there permanently. So, here, he was to learn. And he was teaching those children Narayana, Narayana paro jyotiratma, Narayana paraha antar bahishchatat sarvam vyapya Narayana sthitaha. Now, he was training the other students on Mahanarayana Upanishad. The teachers thought they will lose their job. Stop. What are you teaching? The student said, sir, he is a better teacher. See, well, I used to study in Pilani. We students, I don't know how many of you are Pilanians here. So, we used to have a thought. The research, the teaching students who come, the TAs and RAs, they will teach very well. The age-old postdoctoral professors, when they teach, everything will be overhead transmission. So, they were able to relate to Prahlada, right? Any narration in Kali Yugam has to relate to the audience. Some may ask, why are you using the word Twitter and WhatsApp? If I don't use such words, youngsters will never come. If I say, Swarupa Nirupaka Dharmam Nirupita Swarupa Viseshanam are the qualities as described of the Lord. What did he say just now? I should not prove that I'm a scholar here. This is not the place. There will be learned in the audience. There will be some uninitiated too. I should reach them. That is the Upanyasaka's Dharmam. So this boy was able to reach the audience. They immediately dragged him to the court of Hiranyakashipu and said, sir, your son seems to be incorrigible, irreversible, irreparable. You have your son with you. The father asked, what have you learnt? Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishno, Smaranam, Pada, Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakhyam, Atmanivedanam, Iti Pumsar, Pitar, Vishno, Bhaktischa, Navalakshana. 9 characteristics of pristine devotion is what I've learnt. What do I do with this son? He said, throw him from the mountain. All this you must have heard. I don't have to describe all these violent activities. N.T. Ramarao has already played all those roles. Rangarao. So that is done. So every time he was tormented, the Lord protected. Because it was his belief that protected. Shastram tells, Rakshishyati iti Vishwasaha. It is confidence that protects. See, I go to a bank. I give 1 lakh. They immediately issue 1 FD receipt in 1 lakh in my name. Next day I go again. Namaste madam, yesterday I came. 1 lakh I gave. Is it safe? Safe, sir. Next day I go. Madam, 2 days I've been coming. That 1 lakh, you take your 1 lakh and go. See, I have to believe that banker. Even if the bank is a global trust. I have to believe. Right? Belief comes even in banks. Why can't we bank on the Lord? Rakshishyati iti Vishwasaha. The boy had confidence in the Lord. He said, he has given me, he has blessed me with this unadulterated devotion with which I am speaking. The father tried tormenting him, nothing worked. Finally, he drags the little son to his court. The one who has been protecting you, where is he? I have been telling you, father, he is within the smallest of the small. He is larger than the largest. Anor, Aniyan, Mahato, Mahiyan tells Upanishad. Dasa uses it. Anoraniyana mahato mahiyana aprameyana. Just Vedic statement. That is why Vyasa Tirtha said, this is Purandaropanishad. Purandaradasa's compositions are not just some layman's rambling. It is Upanishad. But to understand that, we must have learnt Upanishads. That is the biggest problem. Right? To relate to it, we must know, right? The boy was able to say, he's within this pillar and within you. No, don't give me irrelevant answers. Is he within this pillar? Yeah. Why are you specific? Because Hiranyakashipu, while he had outsourced the construction of his palace to an architect, he had personally supervised the construction of pillar A. So he was sure nobody could have gotten inside it. Pillar A, pillar A. In Tamil, it is called Tenjipone tape recorder. He'll keep repeating that. So, okay, is he there? The boy said he's there. Sarvatra asti, sada asti, bhuta bhavya bhavat prabhu. He has will, is there. He's very weak in grammar, Hiranyakashipu. He won't understand. You're telling he's within this pillar? Yes. He took the mace in his hand and ran towards the pillar. And as he struck the pillar developed a crack like a dicotyledon. And there came Bhagavatam Mimamsamanasya Samuthito Grato Nisimmarupas Tadalam Bhayanakam Pratapta Chamikara Chandalochanam Spuratkata Kesara Jrumbitananam Karala Damstram Karavala Chanchala Spuranti Jikvam Brukuti Mukolbanam Staddodhakaranam Girikandharadbhuta Vyatatanasam Hanubheda Vishanami Jam Bhukandam Varanandam Paravara Veratam Dambadam Poru Dampam Dim 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 Didimbam Dahamapi Dahamai Jampa Jampaischa Jampais Stulya 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 Duma Duma Dumakai Kunkumankai Kumankai Etatte Purna Yukta Maharakara Harappa Tumam Narasimhaha Bhubrit Bhubrit Bhujangam Pralevavaram Prajwala Jwalamalam Karjajam Kaddadujam Kikachakat Kaddadujayantam Bhubhagam Bhoga Bhagam Gaga Gaga Gaganam Gaddamutyugragantam Swacham Pucham Swagacham Swajanujanita Patumam Narasimhaha Yenabhram Gajamanam Lagulakumakaro Balachandrarkadamstro Hemam Bhojam Sarojam Jada Jadilo Jadyamanas to Bhitihi Dantanam Badhamanam Kakata Kakatavo Bhojajana Surendro Vandenish Pratyuharaja Gaha Gaha Gahataha Patu Tumam Narasimha, Shankam, Chakram, Chachapam, Parashuma, Shamishum, Shulapa, Shankushastram, Vajram, Ketam, Kalamusagala, Kantam, Tukradam, Tram, Dvala, Kesham, Trinetram, Haramusalagadam, Harake, Yurabhusham, Vande Pratyekarupam, Parapadanivasa, Patumam, Narasimha, Nasagram, Pinagandam, Parabaravadanam, Vadake, Yuraharam, Raudram, Damstrakaradam, Mamita Gunagunam, Koti, Suryagninetram, Gambhiriam, Pingalaksham, Brukuta, Vimukam, Shodashad, Ardhavahum, Vande Bhimattahasam, Tribuvana, Vijaya, Patumam, Narasimha, jam 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 jakaram, janu jaji jaji tam janu desham jam jakaram, hum 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 hukaram, harita kahasa yam dishevam bakaram, bam 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 bakaram, badana lalitam vama paksham supaksham, lam lam lakam lam lakaram, laguvana vijaya patumam Narasimha jumped the man lion out of the pillar.
Mani mandira bhakta mandara, vimokya sammohana kara. Avatara Jagannatha Lokadinatha Matsyavatarundavai Somakundram Chivedani Rakshanchi Devasurul Kshiravarani Dildrakshaka Gora Kurmavataram Udai Mandaram Bitti Shri Bhogini Veshamini Shatanam Munigavichi, Varagarupam Muna, Bangabata Babu Devi, Rakshachi, Nadunita Tumulam Bagalini Agnanike, Satyadi Pambu Chupinchi, Moham Varinchi, Ni Vishnu Havam Rupinchi, Nita Sakotin Kataksham Baga, Ni Vichitra Kritim Muni Benchesina. Parandhama Vaikuntha Dhama
Parandhama
Vaikuntha Dhama
Parandhama
Vaikuntha Dhama
Namo Narasimha Namo Bhaktamala
Namo Narasimha Namo Bhagavana
Namo Narasimha Namo Bhagavana
Namo Narasimha Namo Bhagavana
Vidhata dule viragu chinduni Ugra rupamu upasamimpuma
Vidhata dule viragu chinduni Ugra rupamu upasamimpuma
Vedanta Deshika states, Pratyadishta Puratana, by the way, the composition that I recited in Sanskritam is called Shodasha Bahu Stotram, composed by a Madhva saint called Vijayendra Tirtha. It has got the Bijaksharam in it. Very, very important. You must learn it from a guru to recite. It's a very, very, and generally, it is a belief. Now, don't ask me where is the research paper. It is a belief for normal delivery of children. In those days, they used to recite this. Now, don't ask me if we recite this, cesarean won't happen or not. I don't know. It is your belief. Now, the Lord appeared out of the pillar is what we have said. But this is not found in Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam. Rama comes and protects. But being Narasimha devotee, I had to insert Narasimha avataram here. Now, the Lord appeared. He had to suffice the conditions of what Hiranyakashipu had asked. It was a beautiful period where it was neither day nor night. It was a transition phase. It is called Pradosham. Pradosham is that time where it is neither day nor night. So Pradosham is the period. Probably chemistry students will be able to relate in organic chemistry. There's an SN2 mechanism where the carbon leaves a halogen group. This is called transition phase. This is a transition phase. Now, it was that condition was sufficed. He dragged Hiranyakashipu and put him on his lap. Lap is neither space nor earth. He sat on the doorstep, which is neither outside the house nor inside the house. Because most sellers, when they give you houses and they take money, they will take the carpet area inclusive of that doorstep. But when you sell, then the buyer will say, don't include the doorstep. So both of them are confused whether it is outside or inside. It is like a metalloid. Neither metal nor non-metal. So doorstep. And he was a man lion. Akantham Adi Purusham. Below the neck. Adi Purusham. His permanent body. Kantiravam Upari Kunti Taratim. Below the neck. Above the neck was Kantirava. Kantirava is lion. Kantiravam Upari Kunti Taratim. So he was a man lion. The only avataram that blended two different species. Because Homo sapiens... We have heard of this tale. In the north of India, it is often said, while Hanuman was flying, his semen fell. A female crocodile gave birth to a Magaradvaja. All this is not found in Ramayanam. It cannot happen scientifically. Because two different genus and phylum can never get together. But here we had one creation with the man and the lion because this was born in a different way. In Vishnu Sahasranamam, you will come across this name. Ajaha Durmarshanaha Shasta Vishrutatma Surariha. Kelidira? Talayile Atno. So Ajaha. Ajaha in Sanskritam generally means the one who is without birth. Jakaram is birth. Aja means unborn. Ajayamano Bahudha Vijayate. Ajaha means goat as well. That is different. Now Ajaha means unborn. But Ajaha. In Sahasranama, what is the meaning for this? Parashara Bhatta gives the meaning. The one who is born, Nrisimha, unlike others. Unborn doesn't mean not born. He's not born like others. We all come out of the mother's womb. The sac breaks, the water breaks. Then the amniotic fluid comes out. Amnion, chorion, placenta, we are out. But he came out of a pillar. So pillar is his mother. Nobody says here, sir, yesterday I came out of a pillar. If we say even we are Ajaha. He is the only Ajaha known in this world. He has come out of a pillar. He has stayed in the mother's womb, and the mother is an insentient matter, non-living object. So Ajaha, he comes, man-lion. Now, beautiful commentaries on Nisimhavataram. If you listen to it superficially, 1 hour is enough. But to explain Nisimhavataram, you need at least 10 days, 20 hours. Because there is one aspect here. The Lord was himself perplexed. When Prahlada said, my Lord is omnipresent, that is when he realized it seems that he is omnipresent. The Acharya says. So he went and stayed within the pillar. A student 1,000 years back called Nanjiyar asked his teacher, what was the Lord doing within the pillar? How did he spend his time? Yen maadta idru sir alli? Internetu baralla, yenu baralla, yen maadta idru? The Acharya says, he was sharpening his nails. Nakathukku uram pottu kondirundar. This is where pedicure begins. It pediya many adu? Manicure. Manicure begins. Now, the Lord came. Time, everything matched. He took his nails as the weapons. What was the rule? The weapons should neither be animate or inanimate. We believe that nails are generally a set of dead cells except the cuticle part. So that is why when you chop your nails, you won't feel the pain. If you chop your finger, you will. Not the nail. Because it doesn't give you pain, it is treated inanimate. Because it keeps growing after you cut, it is animate. Now how do we understand this? There is another aspect. I'll just get into a little bit of philosophy. ಓ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರು ಸರ್ ಜೀವಾತ್ಮ ಪರಮಾತ್ಮ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಯ್ಯೋ ಏನು ನಾಳೆ ಸಂಜಯ್ ಸುಬ್ರಹ್ಮಣ್ಯಂ ಅವರು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಹಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಏನೋ ಈ ಥರ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ ನೌ ಇನ್ ಫಿಲಾಸಫಿ ರಾಮಾನುಜಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಇಸ್ ಹೇಲ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಫಿಲಾಸಫರ್ಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನಮ್ ಆಪಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಶ್ರೀಭಾಷ್ಯಂ ಇನ್ ಶ್ರೀಭಾಷ್ಯಂ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಹೌ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಹೀ ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟ್ ಆರ್ ಬಕೆಟೆಡ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಚೇತನ ತತ್ವ ಅಚೇತನ ತತ್ವ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬೋತ್ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಈಶ್ವರ ತತ್ವ ಚೇತ್ ಚಿತ್ ಅಚಿತ್ ಈಶ್ವರ ಇಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಲಾಸಫಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಚಿತ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ ಚೇತನ ಚೇತನ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆಕ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಅ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಟಮ್ ಟು ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಚೇತನ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಚಿತ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಟಮ್ ಟು ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಚೇತನ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಚಿತ್ The world comprises of Chit and Achit. Both are controlled by the Lord. But in the world, the logicians argued. Tarkikas they were called. They argued with Ramanuja saying, Chit comes from Chit. See, I have come from my mother. Who is my mother? Chit. The Atma inside her body is Chit. Who is the one within my body? There's Atma, Chit. So Chit has given rise to Chit. Correct? Achit will give rise to Achit. What is the raw material? Let's iron. Iron is used. Iron is a raw material. What is iron? Achit. What has it given rise to? Mike. What is Mike? Achit. So Achit will give rise to Achit. Chit will give rise to Chit. This is the formula. The Tarkikas argued with Ramanuja, you say that the world comprises of Chit and Achit. Who is the one who has given birth to both of them? Ramanuja said Ishvara. What is Ishvara? Does he have Chaitanyam or not? Yes, he has Chaitanyam. That means he is also Chit. No, if you take him as Chit, then there is no need for a third category. He will naturally fall. So he is called Super Chit. Super Chaitanyam. So this is the third category. So Chit gives rise to Chit is understandable. Achit gives rise to Achit is understandable. But Ramanuja, you say that Lord who is Chit has given rise to Chit and Achit. How is it possible? Ramanuja gave one example in Sribhashyam. One is that of a scorpion. The scorpion is very, very special. Because if you take we, the humans, or most mammals, we are all viviparous. We have all come out from the mother directly. She doesn't lay one egg. and incubate that egg. We have come out of the mother directly. There was an egg within her. It got into a blastocyst, fertilized, and then we have come out. So we are all viviparous. Whereas birds are oviparous. From the mother comes the egg. The egg is outside the mother and the egg gets incubated to give a chick. Correct? So they are oviparous and we are viviparous. But scorpions are ovoviviparous. The little one from the mother comes in the egg and that egg doesn't come out. It is inside the mother. So while the chick, the little scorpion has to come out, it needs heat. So the mother scorpion will require heat. In those days, every household used to have a cow shed. The mother scorpions which are pregnant will know where the cow will lay the dung. The dung when it is laid will be super hot. So they will go position themselves in the cow shed where the parabolic motion of that cow dung will come. And in that heat it gets incubated and the little scorpion comes out. Now, to an onlooker, he doesn't see the mother scorpion. He sees cow dung. Suddenly he sees a little scorpion coming out. What will he think? The cow dung is achit, but it is giving rise to a scorpion which is chit. So the converse is possible, Ramanuja said. If you get inside philosophy, you will find this is the best civilization. That is why we don't get into. The next example, Ramanuja states, the human body has jivatma which is chit, but it gives rise to nails which is achit. So chit gives rise to achit, achit gives rise to chit. If these two conditions suffice, what is wrong in you assuming that God has given rise to both chit and achit, he asks. Then he concludes, in Narasimhavataram, both are exemplified. Where did Narasimha stay? In a pillar. What is pillar? Achit. What is Narasimha? Chit. So achit, the pillar, has given rise to Narasimha, which is the chit. Narasimha, who is the chit, with the achit called nails tore Hiranyakashipu apart. So both examples come in Narasimha Avataram. So Narasimha Avataram is one incarnation that proves the philosophy of Sanatana Dharma, tells Ramanuja. Thank God. Since you're all a learned audience, you were able to appreciate. Because only with such intense listening that you have all done for years will you be able to grasp it immediately. That is why there is a word called Medha Vilasam, if you have heard that word. What is Medha Vilasam? When someone speaks, you should comprehend at the same rate in which he speaks. That is called Medha Vilasam. If you say, wait, tell again. Modrinda heli, hogbidate, Medha Vilasam. You should follow the same rate in which your acharya tells. In those days, there was no repeat. In concerts, you say, Innon Sari Hadi, once more. In acharya's kalakshepam, you'll have to do it at one go. So Nrisimha came and tore Hiranyakashipu apart. Acharya says that he was searching for something within the body of Hiranyakashipu. They were asking the Lord, what are you searching? Because from this Hiranyakashipu has come Prahlada, a gem. I'm searching if there is another gem within him. To pacify the Lord, Lakshmi was brought into picture. To pacify the Lord. This is there in Puranams. Prahlada Bhakti Vijayam does not talk about it. But how did they pacify the goddess Lakshmi and ask goddess to pacify the Lord? There is no very clear composition. Here is one composition that you will listen to in Bilahari Ragam, Pahi Pahi Amrita Valli.
Pahi Pahi Amrita Valli Kripa Kari Vatsale.
Amen.
Prahlada must have prayed to Mother Goddess Amritavalli to pacify the Lord. This is a Sanskrit composition that I have done in Bilahari Ragam. So, since I found this particular portion where seeking goddesses' intervention was not there in our scriptures, I had to fill that small section, and they have set it to tune so beautifully in the Ragam Bilahari. And it deploys both the Divyadesha Mudra and the Raga Mudra. Aho Bilahari Priyakari. Aho Bila Hari Priyakari. So she is found in Aho Bila Kshetram, as well as she is the one who is blessed with Hari, who is Nisimha. So the boy goes and pacifies, and then the Lord is pacified and he asks, "My dear devotee Prahlada, what do you want?" He should have asked me. I would have had a list. The boy says, "What more do I want with your presence, which itself is such an ambrosia to my eyes? I wouldn't need anything else," he says. Tyagaraja puts this beautifully, where Prahlada conveys to the Lord, "I wouldn't need anything else but the glimpse of your lotus-like eyes." Varija nayana nivadanu. So we can listen to that beautiful kriti.
Bye.
Prahlada, the end of this process, he could sense the Lord within him. Aparoksha jnanam and pratyaksham. So what he was aspiring for through his intense meditation, austerities and devotion is the presence of the Lord and the inseparability from the Lord. Apritak siddha viseshanam tells Ramanuja. So he was with the Lord in his thoughts. So he saw the entire world as Harimayam, tells Tyagaraja. This devotion reached its zenith while he was meditating on the Lord. And that Hari, incidentally, Hari means Harir Harati Papani, the one who is able to steal the sins that we have committed. Hari also means the lion. So to that Hari, he offered his obeisances. And Tyagaraja does that of Prahlada through Rama. He sees the Hari in Rama. While he expresses devotion, our acharyas have hailed the presence of Nrisimha in so many kshetras, divyadeshams in Archavatar. You go to Melukote, there is a beautiful hillock on which is a beautiful yoga Nrisimha. You go to Tondanur, there is a Nrisimha. You go to Thiruvananthapuram, before getting into the sanctum sanctorum of Ananta Padmanabha, there is a Nrisimha. You go from Ambalapurai to Ernakulam, Thuravur, you'll find Nrisimha. You go to Chola Simhapuram, which is Sholingar Thirukkadigai, Mikkanai, Marayai, Virinda, Vilakkai, Ennul, Pukkanai, Pugalsher, Poliginna, Punmalayai, Takkanai, Tadigai, Kunnin, Mishayirinda, Akkarakkaniyai, Adaindu, Indu, Ponene, tells Alvar of Sholingar Thirukkadigai. You go to Shingapirumal Kovil near Vandalur, Padaladri, Nrisimha. You go to Thiruvali Thirunagari of Thirunangur Divadesham, Nrisimha. You find Nrisimha within the Srirangam premises as Metalagishingar and outside as Kattalagishingar, near Kaveri as Atralagishingar. You go to Ahobilam, you find 9 Nrisimhas, Jwala, Ahobilam, Alola, Kroda, Karanja, Bhargavaha, Yogananda, Chhatravata, Pavano, Navamurtayaha. You go to Kadiri, Nrisimha. Mattapalli, Kashyapa worshipped and Bharadwaja worshipped Nrisimha. Vadapalli, Nrisimha. Vedadri, the physician Nrisimha. Mangalagiri, the Panaka Nrisimha, Penchalakonna, the Nrisimha with stretched legs. Yadagiri Gutta near Bhagyanagaram, Nrisimha. You go to Simhachalam, Varaha Nrisimha. You go before the Purushottama Kshetram of Puri, entrance you will find Nrisimha. You go to the beautiful hill of Yanaimalai near Tirumohur, Madurai, you will find Nrisimha. You go to Hampi, you will find a beautiful relic of Nrisimha. You go to Singri, you find Nrisimha with 16 hands near Kadalur. Nrisimha is spread everywhere. Trailokya metad akhilam Narasimha garbham. To that Nrisimha whom Prahlada sensed everywhere, he says a beautiful kriti and offers a mangalam, which is the universal mangalam. Everybody sings this. That's a part of this natakam.
Bang.
ಮಂಗ